Now, ladies and gentlemen, Stephanie Gould in Walk With Me.
It was on one Monday morning, just about 1 o'clock, when that great ship Titanic began to reel and rock. People began to scream and cry, saying, Lord, am I going to die? It was sad when that great ship went down. It was sad. It was sad. It was...
Not many people know this, but Leonardo DiCaprio and I were together for 2 years. The king of the world and I were attached at the hip. Seriously, his arms were around my hips. Leo was all mine, and I learned to live with his quirks. We'd glide across the floor together, and everyone would watch. Stare, really, but still. Sometimes being with him would be really annoying. We'd have to find special entrances and exits everywhere. I'd get out of bed in the morning, and my back would be really, really sore. Still, I'd crawl back into his arms. When we broke up, I was really afraid to be away from him. I thought he was the only one who understood me. He really pushed me along, you know? Oh, Leonardo DiCaprio was the name of my wheelchair. I named it that so I could sit in his lap. When I was 13, I had to learn how to walk again, which is how I ended up with Leo here.
It was sad when that great ship went down. Husbands and wives, little children lost their lives. It was sad when that great ship went down.
I have cerebral palsy, a mild form of it anyways, called hemiparesis. It affects my left side, makes it a lot weaker. Sometimes I have to work extra hard to do really simple things, like when I used to pick something up with my left hand, I wouldn't be able to let it go. The doctor would say, okay, Stephanie, you can release the pen now. But I couldn't. My hand would just get stuck. So he'd have to show me. One, two. One, two. My brain knew what to do, but my body wouldn't listen. It's stubborn that way. So recently, I've taken up yoga. Namaste. But when I was 7, I wanted to play the violin. Not like a concert violinist or anything. I just thought it was fun. It was like physical therapy, you know? It helped my hand. I don't have my violin here, no. My mother says I shouldn't subject anyone to something that sounds like a dying cat. I don't blame her, I wasn't that good, but it helped my hand, apparently, because I can do this. I'm in the top percentile of people who have CP, like a big miracle or something. Step right up, ladies and gentlemen. Step right up and see the miracle baby hold and let go of a pencil. She can even pinch her fingers together, and she can talk. She never shuts up. All still true. I even made the rounds on the morning show and telethon circuit in the 80s. Seriously.
And it was making for the shore. The rich refused to associate with the poor. So it put the poor below. They were the first to go.
I was born 3 months premature, so I wasn't done developing. And my right leg came out all wonky, like an undercooked lasagna. So not only did I have CP on my left side, my right side wasn't done cooking, so they had to correct it. Because when God was handing out bullshit, he gave me extra. The surgery to correct my leg took 7 hours. That's half a day. Like Sleeping Beauty. If Sleeping Beauty was a puffy-faced, post-op 13-year-old. They straightened my leg, you know? They took my hip off, straightened it, took my kneecap off, straightened that, took my foot, ankle off. Well, you get the idea. It was a big jumbled mess. They put metal in here. I'm like the bionic woman. If the bionic woman was a single, puffy-faced 32-year-old. It hurt a lot. And the funny thing is, the doctor asked me if I wanted to walk. He was like, do you want to be able to walk when you're 20? Yeah, Doc, I do. Thanks for asking. I wanted to walk. Growing up, I wanted to be an actor, like Leo, too. To be able to tell stories for a living would be amazing. I also loved dancing. I wasn't very good at it, but I did it, and I wouldn't be able to do any of that if I couldn't walk. I had to quit dance. Damn surgery. I took classes in a tiny studio. It wasn't much bigger than this room. They were the only place in my city to let me in. Others were afraid, I think. Maybe I'd ruined the perfect image of what it means to be a child dancer. It's not like I was stumbling around and bumping into everything all the time. I mean, I'll admit, I'm a tad klutzy. But did they really have to exclude me? And at least I didn't pee on the stage. Nicole. My dad is the best. No, I'm pretty sure mine's the best. I was born the day before my dad's birthday, so I'm pretty sure I'm the most expensive gift he's ever got. I'm also pretty sure I'm non-returnable. Pretty sure. I can say with absolute certainty that I am the lightest gift he's ever received. I was 1 pound, 10 ounces when I was born, which is basically the size of a tiny chicken. I was also see-through, kind of like E.T. See? My dad looks like he's gonna eat me. He also looks like Magnum P.I. with that mustache. Before my surgery, he bought me a bunch of magazines with Leonardo DiCaprio's face on the cover so I'd have something nice to look at when I went under anesthesia. Did you know I missed Titanic? I was having a 7-hour surgery and my 13-year-old brain was thinking about seeing a movie. Naturally. I wish I could see Leonardo DiCaprio right now. I bet he's perfect. Still. Well, nobody's really perfect. Leo was in The Man in the Iron Mask, after all. I'd have another surgery than see that movie again. But he was so cute. Anyways, I have this stringy thing in my head. Well, I have this thing called a shunt. See? It's thin like spaghetti. And it feels like it, too. It keeps me alive. It drains the fluid that would have built up in my brain and gone off the side and made my head swell up like a damn cantaloupe, and it puts it back into my bloodstream. Plumbing. One of my best friends even says, yes, Stephanie, you are a true Italian, because you have spaghetti flowing through your body. When I was 10, they had to put in a new one. This is the old one. They shaved underneath here, and they had to go all the way down to here. I looked like an 80s punk rocker. I don't think my mother would have liked it if they shaved off all my hair. She likes my curls. To this day, if I put my hair back, I can practically hear my mother sighing all the way from Massachusetts. It scared me the other day. Seriously, I have so much hair, I should just give it a name like a pet. Horace. That sounds like a good name for something that looks like a baby gremlin.
It was sad when that great ship went down. While they were building, they said what they would
do. I can't believe I had to learn to walk again. I got 2 bum legs. The left one was just getting used to being a weirdo. And the right one I could do anything with. It was super duper strong. I could skip. I had just learned how to skip, okay? Now I couldn't skip. Nope. No skipping for me. I should just join a freak show or something. Do they still have those? The kids, they made fun of me before all the surgery. One girl, she was considered popular, probably because she was mean. She'd imitate how I walked all crooked and stuff, and not very well, might I add. And it wasn't just the other kids who made fun of me either. I was in third grade, and I wore a dress to school because my mother always wanted me to dress nice. I never really wore pants. Well, I thought this was just because I was wearing a dress that this happened, but it turns out my teacher thought I couldn't do anything, and he called me retarded.
Oh.
I'm sorry, that's not right. Retarded! Boston, yep. One of my very own teachers called me that. He even started laughing, which is weird, because I was under the impression that teachers were supposed to be nice and stuff, which now I realize is total bullshit. I was told to sit out of class because I looked funny when I ran and I couldn't keep up with the other kids. All because I moved around a little funny. There's a very specific way I walk, okay? Very specific. And if anyone is gonna show you how to move like me, it's me. Anyone with CP will tell you that. It depends on the person. Some of us can't control our muscles and our bodies jerk back and forth a lot. Some of us can't walk. Some of us can't talk. Some of us use crutches. And some of us use a wheelchair named Leonardo DiCaprio. All of us can think and feel, though. We all have a heart and a brain, otherwise we'd be dead.
The water can go through, but God with power and hand will go through.
I just wanted to fit in. We all want that. Before my surgery, I played basketball, too. Again, not very well. I have movement issues, clearly. But it worked out better than the dance in a way, because my intensity for the game could just be chopped up to being really into the game. I got to run around like a spastic chicken. All was well. We would have games on Sundays. The ball would hit me in the face a lot. I even broke my glasses a couple of times, and I had to take foul shots and made them. Like a big Lifetime movie moment or something. But it wasn't the actual games on Sundays I remember, though. My grandparents lived downstairs. And my grandmother used to make everything from scratch. I mean, who does that anymore? God, I can still smell her sauce. And let me be clear, it's sauce. Not gravy. Gravy's that brown stuff you put on a turkey, okay? Sauce. God, the sauce and the meatballs and the pork chops all simmering together like an awesome trio I couldn't wait to eat. It didn't matter if I won the game or not. At least I had Nana's cooking to come home to. Comfort. And Nana. Come to think of it, that's all I wanted to eat after I got out of the hospital. I just wanted to lie in bed and have pasta and Nana sauce.
It was sad. It was sad when the great ship went down. Husbands and wives, little children lost their lives. It was sad.
It's a miracle I'm not crazy. My aunt and uncle came to visit me one night in the hospital. And my uncle barely leaned against the bed. I freaked. I screamed about a long red leash and branches coming out of the ceiling because I was on some really heavy drugs, okay? It turns out that long red leash was a set of tubes coming out of my hip that was draining the fluid that built up during the operation. And those branches? Window blinds. My doctor's one question, "Do you want to walk when you're 20? Turned me into a monster. I was hungry. It hurt. I wanted Nana's food, but they couldn't give me any. The anesthesia has to wear off for a bit or you'll get sick. You know what they gave me? A button. This button. A magic button. The magic comes from taking the pain away. Kinda. I wasn't an idiot. I'm still not an idiot. They gave me morphine. I thought they said morphin, like Mighty Morphin Power Rangers. So when I pushed the button, Mighty Morphin Power Rangers, go! Mighty Morphin Power Rangers, go! Go, go, Power Rangers! Do you know they lock these things so you don't overdose? But if you've ever used one of these, you know you'd take the overdose over the pain. Took so much blood before the operation, just in case anything went wrong. Well, nothing really went wrong, so I guess there's just pints of my blood hanging out somewhere. Even my blood got to hang out. Go to the movies. See Titanic. I mean, I saw Romeo and Juliet in the theater twice. And I still hadn't seen Titanic. A girl in my class, she had her first kiss the week before I went into the hospital. I wanted to get kissed by a boy, but who wanted to kiss the girl in the wheelchair? I couldn't even chase him. I could run him over and drag him behind me. Kidnapping. That would be weird. The kidnapping assault thing, not the wheelchair thing. I did have my first kiss, though, at 19. It was awkward and weird. He's gay now. I guess he was born that way. I didn't have it that bad. Some kids, they've been trapped in this thing their whole life, no way out. Their parents helped them too. They don't even go to a real school. And when I was born, they said I'd be that way too. They told my parents, she'll never walk. If you're lucky, she'll talk. And if you can afford it, send her to a special school. It's not my mom's fault I came into this world early. I hope she knows that. She was sick. She had preeclampsia. Her kidneys shut down. They had to take me out. They had to save her life. I'm just glad both of us made it out alive. And just when I thought I put all that behind me, middle school hits. And not only did I want to ask, the cute boy in my class to the dance, I wanted to dance. I wanted to walk. I wanted to be free. I wanted for all the pain that I went through to correct me to pay off. But I had too many reminders. Scarred for life. My medical records must have been written by a comedy writer or something.
Hilarious.
Instead of your typical mommy and me classes, I was in occupational and physical therapy. Woohoo! Seriously, there are so many gems in here. Check out this one from when I was 3 years old. Stephanie was quite verbal and interested in activities, though she had some difficulty staying in her seat after the first 5 to 10 minutes, and was somewhat distractible. However, she was able to imitate a train, bridge, and pyramid. I still have a wicked awesome pyramid impression. And the train, choo-choo. I don't know how to do a bridge, I don't remember. Hey, do you know how to do a bridge impression? Oh my god! That's real good! There came a point, though, even during those formative hormonal years where Leo here was just getting in the way. I had to move on. Like, literally, I had to move on. I had to do whatever I wanted to set my mind to, and that was walk. I wanted for everything I went through to pay off.
Those people on that ship were a long ways from home. With friends all around, I didn't know that time had come. Yep.
A few years ago, I got a tattoo and really pissed my dad off. See, I got the stereotypical white chick tattoo. Feast your eyes on the Chinese symbol for strength. Like a basic white chick who doesn't know what she's talking about. Pumpkin spice lattes every morning. Never in a hot yoga class. And fails miserably at flirting with the hot yoga dude who has too many chicks after him and not enough time. And also like a basic white chick, above that is a flower. But not just any flower. A cherry blossom. Apparently one of the first things you learn as a tattoo artist because it's so basic. But don't forget the petals. Those are important too. Symbolism and all. Has to mean something after all. But unlike those basic white chicks with their pumpkin spice lattes and way too tight yoga pants, my tattoo actually means something, you bastards. See, I put my tattoo on my left side, my CP side, right above one of my scars. And despite what my dad says, this is not a tramp stamp. A tramp stamp goes on your lower back. Half of the program. This is a scar of a different color. Literally. It's pink and colorful, and it's an intentional scar. I chose it. I chose to put this scar in my body. For years, I had people telling me that I'd have to have something done that I didn't choose. Surgery sucks, and scars from surgeries suck. These constant reminders that something was different, that something went wrong, that I was a monster. This scar is on my ankle. This scar I chose to remind me that I am strong, that I'm a fighter, that there will be good luck around the corner, and that life is short. This scar is beautiful. This scar is mine. I mean, we all know you have a lot of experience with ice and snow. I really don't think you deserve the Oscar for The Revenant. There's also the distance thing. I live in New York now. And I've been dating, which is weird. I never thought I'd be considered the normal one in the relationship. I'm getting used to this whole normal thing in general. People don't realize what I've been through, and that you were there to help. But it's all good, because I finally feel like I'm coming into my own.